Well, hey everybody, I'm Nathaniel Dodson from tutvid.com. Welcome into this Adobe After Effects tutorial, where today we're going to talk about a little bit of rotoscoping, but mainly creating pretty complex selections that follow your video and that work beautifully. In fact, we're going to be extracting a head of hair over a not green screen background. It's bit of a solid color background maybe, but it's not green screen, so technically it's not green screen. If you enjoy this video and you learn something from it, consider supporting our channel and subscribing to the channel so you never miss any video editing, After Effects, Premiere Pro, you name it, tutorials in the past, present, or future. And with that out of the way, ladies and gentlemen, let's jump into After Effects and get this show on the road. Alrighty, ladies and gents, here we are in Adobe After Effects. Now, instead of the traditional rotoscoping method of drawing a Bezier curve around an object with the pen tool, an object that you want to cut out or track or move in front of another object or special effect or whatever it may be, and then adjusting it frame to frame to frame to frame to frame in that monotonous and very tedious, you know, do it over and over and over again task, we have in After Effects access to a tool called the Roto Brush, and it's actually pretty solid. Let me show it to you and show you how we can apply some rotoscoping here to this image, particular to this young lady playing the guitar. We're going to add some text that's going to read rotoscope, that's going to sort of float in midair. So I will grab the text tool, and I'm just going to type out the word rotoscope, and the light blue actually works perfectly. So I'll commit those changes, and I'll grab my selection tool. We'll drag it somewhere right around here, but I'll use my align panel, make sure I'm aligning to the composition, and align, so it's just, you know, side to side, horizontally, so it's centered up for us. Now you can see, obviously, the text appears over her face. We don't want that. We actually want the text to appear in space behind her. So what we'll do is we'll select the musician video clip layer, Command or Control D to duplicate it, and I'll hit the Enter Return key, and we'll just call this layer Roto, or, you know, we can call it Front. I don't know. I'm misspelling everything today. I'm going to drag this up on top of the text, and now the text disappears because we got a piece of video on top of it. But now comes the process that we actually rotoscope this thing out. So in order to use the Roto Brush, which is right here, you can see that nothing's happening here when I'm just in my composition, because the Roto Brush, it likes to work directly on the video. So you got to double click here. So we'll double click to get within the front video clip here. And you can see we're in the front layer, right? Here's our composition here. We're inside this layer. And now I have this little green spot. If I hold down my Command or Control key and drag up or down, that's how I change the size of the brush. I'll make a reasonably sized brush, maybe something like this. And you just draw a line kind of down the middle of the thing you want After Effects to select. You can see we got this little pinkish, purplish outline. It's not at all selected what we want selected. It's selected some of what we want selected, but not nearly all of it. So you can just click and add to the selection. So we'll just click and add there. We'll say, yeah, come on up over here. Get all that hair, right? She's got this crazy hair. And we'll go ahead and get this bit here and just try to get a little bit more of the back there. And this little scarf action thing she's got, maybe that's just her shirt actually, the back of the guitar. And then heading down her hand, I'll hold down Command or Control, drag downward a little bit. Let's go ahead and get out here to the neck and the head of the guitar, see if we can get kind of all that stuff. I really don't think the guitar is going to make that much of a difference, honestly, though, because remember, our text is up here, and unless she throws the guitar up into midair, I don't really think it's going to make all that much of a difference if we get a perfect selection down here, that is. But just for the sake of being consistent, I'm going to make sure I have it all selected and, relatively decent. Now, this is one thing. I can view this in a couple different ways. I can toggle the alpha channel. You can see just a super rough selection, right? Not very usable. I can go with this red opaque, kind of like quick mask mode in Photoshop. What do they call it here in After Effects? Oh, the alpha overlay, of course. And then there's this sort of pink overlay, which just shows us that little boundary that we were just viewing. So we can see kind of the edges that After Effects sees. Now, I want to clean this up even more than I've already done. And well, we haven't really cleaned it up at all, but you know what I'm saying. We want to clean up the selection. That's where the Refine Edge tool comes into play. Again, you hold down your Command or Control key, and we can make our brush bigger or smaller. I'll make this a little bit bigger. Let's try painting over the edge of her hair first and just see how this does. So I'm going to go ahead, pull this right around here and into the front of her face, kind of like so. And you're going to see we get this really weird-looking effect. And what this is basically this is sort of an alpha display of what we just did. The black stuff is not going to be selected. The white stuff, including all those fine little pixely details, that stuff is going to be selected and rotoscoped. So that's really, really cool. We can shut it off, by the way, by just toggling the little Refine Edge X-ray option. You see, they call it a nice little fancy name. And we can just see a really kind of glowy edge. I kind of like the X-ray, though, because it looks really impressive and it lets me know I'm getting something done. I'm going to make my brush here a little smaller. I'm going to pull down across the front of her face and try to get the hair behind her chin there. There we go. That's cool. And then we maybe could use this down on the head of the guitar and her hand, something like that. And we'll see. It's doing an okay job. I mean, it doesn't look like it's perfect, but I think it's good enough. And then back here where the guitar strap kind of pushes the jacket in, maybe I'll give this a little love back there as well. But I think that's all we need to do in terms of making our initial rotoscope and then cleaning up and refining the edges of this sort of selection, if you will. And what we can do is begin dragging the playhead and these little arrows. This is the amount that After Effects has sort of scoped out and created paths and stuff for. You can see the green is what's rendering through. It's going to catch up to us here in just a moment. But it only does up to 20 frames at a time, I believe is the number that After Effects will give you, 20 frames at a shot. But once it catches up to us, you'll see the arrow line is going to extend down our timeline further. And we'll see an updated pink outline and see what it's doing for us. And if we have to adjust the Roto Brush, we can do that. Now you can see here, we still have a nice outline, a nice selection right in there. It's still selecting her little shirt. Everything here looks pretty solid. I kind of dig it. Let's go ahead and choose the Roto Brush once again. I'll just click a single time here in the middle. It's going to sort of re-render. You can see it's pushing out another 20 frames. Great. Let's move down our timeline a little bit further and see what it's doing. Let it render up behind us. And you can see here, at this point, it's still doing really great with her hair, but it's kind of gone ahead and expanded the selection a little bit down here. So I can just hold down my Alt or Option key and say, yeah, just subtract that bit of the selection. We don't want that. Yep, there you go. And it just clips to the guitar again. And we can just continue bumping this down the timeline, down the timeline, down the timeline, and letting After Effects do this work for us instead of having to re-rotoscope and adjust our Bezier curve on every single frame or just about every single frame as you know, you would have to do if you use the pen tool to create a rotoscope or to track a mask or do any of this kind of stuff that we're doing. Now, if you go over this whole thing and you realize, you know what, I've really got an effect that I like, the scoping is following exactly where I want it to go, I'm going to get a selection or I'm going to get a mask or I'm going to get what I want from the Roto Brush, we can go ahead and hit the little freeze option, which will go through our entire rotoscoped clip and just lock it in. So it's not going to change again if we come in here and start messing around with something. We're not going to accidentally mess up what was a perfect rotoscope. You can see here we need to just hold down Alt or Option and just get rid of that. And really all you do is just draw over it like that. I want to make sure I get the rest of her guitar here and also her hand and then also this part of her hand out here as well. And in fact, at this point, I'm going to select composition, get back to here, and we can see that the rotoscoping has done a really nice job of cutting her out perfectly. I mean, look at the detail that it got from the edge of the hair. There's a little bit of grayness, but almost a little bit of shadow. Looks kind of nice, right? And you can see she's just floating right in front of the text, and as she moves, the rotoscope is just keeping up with her and making that really, really complex edge look pretty stinking nice. And it's all done, creating incredible selections, rotoscopes, masks, tracked masks. Here in After Effects, the Roto Brush tool is quite powerful indeed. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. As you can see, a super useful little function, feature, you know, whatever you want to call it here in Adobe After Effects to create nice, complex, rotoscoping, moving selections, mats, masks, all kinds of different useful things that this tool and this particular technique can be used for. I hope you really enjoyed it for learning a little bit about the Roto Brush and also the Refine Edge Brush in Adobe After Effects. That's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.